to the next type. All right. Do you
so
think,
doctor, we know that these products are required for a good skincare, but how do you actually use them properly? Like, you know, because every one of us are loaded with so many products, we know they are good for us, good skincare.
Right. See, that I think is a very, very relevant and a very important question. How to use. So now, especially in the lockdown, we all have a lot of time on our hands. So we must follow the 1 minute golden rule for skincare. When you apply a cleanser to your face, just massage it very, very gently. And especially if you have an oily skin, then you must not use the cleanser around the eye. This area should be left alone, especially if you're using a medicated harsh cleanser. But if you're using a gentle cleanser, then you can wash the eye area also. So clean it nicely like this for about 1 minute. But if it, at the end you feel that the skin has come too dry, then maybe next time you can decrease the contact time to 30 seconds, but no less than 30 seconds to wash your face. After you wash your face, just pat dry and give it some time, maybe 30 seconds to 60 seconds before you apply the active medicine. And by active medicine, I mean a serum, which can be either a vitamin C serum, which you can use both as an antioxidant, anti-blemish serum in this season in the morning, or you can use a dry cream, which we might have given you for acne-prone skin. So these are the kinds of active medicines which are available in serums or cream formulations. And this comes immediately after washing your face. What I suggest is you put them on and spread them very lightly. Do not massage these active medicines. After you've applied the serum or the drying cream, wait for a minute and then apply the moisturizer. See, for the moisturizer, what you need to do is put it on right from the neck to the forehead, dab it on like you would dab on a foundation, and then massage. This massage has to be in an upward direction, starting from the neck and going towards the forehead. At the forehead, you can either massage upwards, that's ideal, or you can massage towards the sides. Please take 1 minute to do this kind of massage. What you're doing by doing this massage is effectively activating the skin lymphatics, which are going to work to take away the toxins from your skin. And they also work to take away the edema fluid, right? So this will work as what we do in the clinic. When we give you a hydrafacial or some kind of another facial, this is the kind of massage that we do. We are activating the lymphatics in an upward direction, which takes away the toxins. After you've applied the moisturizer, wait for a minute, wait for it to get absorbed totally, and then apply the sunscreen. The method of applying the sunscreen is absolutely the same, except the upper eyelid area. Please do not use any chemical sunscreen on the upper eyelid area. Let it be. You can apply here, especially if you use a day cream for the under eye area. You must cover it up with a sunscreen, but the upper eyelid area has to be avoided while using a sunscreen. A similar 1 minute rule can be followed at night when you're applying your night cream, and that night cream should then be followed up by the moisturizer. Does that satisfy your query?
Yes, it is. Thank you.
All right. Then coming to the next most important thing, the lockdown survival guide. You can't come to us, you can't go to spas, you can't go to parlors, you can't call the parlor girls home. So what do you do? See, what I suggest for your threading, what you can do is take a shaving mirror, right? It is going to enlarge the picture that you see. And take a small ruler and a liquid eyeliner and make an outline of the brow that you want. Don't try to reshape it too much, just the extra areas have been marked. This is what we do when we do microblading also. We've marked the area with a liquid liner and then you just use a pair of tweezers to remove the extra hair. Please don't try to do too much to your eyebrows because then we won't be able to help you. So just try and remove the extra hair. It's a very simple thing to do. You will need around 10 to 15 minutes. But it should be good. And you'll be good for about 2 weeks and then you can repeat the process. And the next is the laser patients, the patients who can't come in for lasers, who can't get vaccine, then what to do? I think it's a very, very simple thing. And if you've been coming to me for lasers, I've been advising this to all the patients to shave at home and come. Now, how to shave at home? What you do is have a bath, use a loofah. This loofah helps in gently exfoliating the dead skin cells and releasing the hair that are trapped in this dead skin cell, right? Then use any simple razor and shave in a single direction from up to down. By up to down, I mean for your arm, you shave towards the hand, and for your legs, you shave towards the feet. A single direction, go from up to down, pick up your razor, go to the next area, then shave from up to down. This simple method of using a razor is going to protect you from razor cuts, razor rashes. And you'll be good with this kind of razor. You'll be good for about a week, and then you can repeat it till the time we find it safe to open a clinic for laser. Then pedicure. It's in fact a very, very easy thing to do. I know we all have this thing, we don't do it ourselves. We always have these parlor girls to do it for us. But in fact, not a very difficult thing to do at home. What you can do is one night a week, take a bucket full of warm water and to it add 2 tablespoons of Meeta soda or soda bicarbonate. It's easily available in the kitchen. And for extra cleansing, you can add either shampoo or a body wash and dip your feet in it for about 10 to 12 minutes and then scrub off the dead skin. You can either use a foot scrubber or a pumice stone or an abrasive towel if you have it. And for the cuticle, if you have a nail filer, which has a cuticle remover at the end, probably you can use that, or you can use any old used toothbrush. Again, a word of caution here, please do not try to remove all the cuticles or all the dead skin cells in one go. Be gentle, repeat the process. In case you feel you want to repeat it twice a week, you can do it twice a week. But in case you introduce a cut or you're too abrasive and there's a fungal infection, it's going to be difficult in this lockdown. So do not overdo it. And for a hair spa, I think nothing works better than coconut oil. Just apply the oil at night. If you have dry scalp, dry hair, and there's no tendency to acne on your face, there's no tendency to acne, to dandruff on the scalp, you can apply this oil overnight and wash up the next morning. But if you have oily skin, please do not attempt it at night. You can probably use the oil for an hour maybe before you wash your hair. That's it. All right. So Zoom is saying that they want to extend the time beyond 40 minutes for the meeting. So I would like to welcome any questions that you have at this time.
Okay, so doctor, what about scrubbing? Should we be doing scrubbing these days? And if yes, then should we go for the commercial ones or the homemade scrubbings?
Yeah, whatever you have. If you have a commercial scrub, yes, you can use it. And if you don't have it, then you can probably use oats mixed with either milk or rose water, or you can use coarsely crushed almonds. You can use those also as a scrub. But if you have sensitive skin, I think you should use only basin. Basin mixed with either rose water or a little unboiled milk. That's good enough for sensitive skin. But the most important thing is how you scrub. So main thing is you should scrub on a well-cleaned face only. So first, wash your face. Use the face wash or the cleanser that you're using regularly. Wash your face nicely. Wash your hands nicely. Only then try the scrubbing. Don't do it like this. For example, if I walked in like this, I should not scrub my face like this because there's so much chemical on it already in the form of a cream or a sunscreen. And if I am scrubbing, I'm removing the dead skin and I'm forcefully introducing the chemicals into my skin. So first, we should clean our skin nicely and then scrub. The scrubbing has to be gentle. It has to be in a circular motion like this. Mm-hmm. Right. Okay. Ideally, only use your fingertips for the scrub. But whether or not it's a commercial or a homemade scrub, it's fine. For oily skin, I think it's better to avoid all forms of scrub. The skin is already inflamed, there's acne, it's irritated, and we don't want the infection to spread. Please wait for some time. Let us open the clinic and we'll deal with your acne. Don't try to scrub it at home.
Okay. And how about the mask? Do you think masks also cause allergies to the skin?
Do you mean the medicated mask?
The face masks, mask? Yeah.
Yes.
The face masks we get from the market, yeah.
Yeah, they are causing a lot of allergies because the material is such. So okay. What you need to do is, before you apply that mask going out of the house, you need to use a good quality moisturizer and sunscreen. Wait for these products to get absorbed and form a thick layer on your skin, and then wear those masks. Especially if you're using the N95, they have a steel strip in them, which can cause a lot of pressure on your nose and can irritate, and I've seen allergies with it also. So in that case, what you can do is probably keep a little bit of cotton on your nose before you apply the N95, but make sure that the occlusion is not tampered with. Otherwise, the purpose of the mask would be defeated.
Okay. All right. And what about some home remedies during these lockdown days?
Before the lockdown also, I was not a big fan of putting anything from the kitchen onto your face. And I see no reason to change it now. You know, because every single day I get so many questions from people who've tried lemon or who've tried tomatoes, who've tried honey on their face, and they're breaking out or they have developed this rash and they don't know what to do. So I think it's from my side, please, if you've not used these things before, please do not go ahead and apply anything and everything on your face just because it's a lockdown. For the fruit, follow one mantra till the time you have teeth. Chew your fruit, do not pulp it and put it on your face, because we do not know what kind of enzyme reaction is going to take place on your face. For example, lemon, right? I'm seeing so many social media influencers putting masks or DIY masks with lemon. And every single day I get a query that last night I tried this mask with lemon and now my skin is burning like crazy. It's turning red. So this is a known problem with lemon. It causes a reaction with the sun. This is known as phytophotodermatitis, guys. Please, please, please do not put these things on your face. Just use a simple cleanser, moisturizer, sunscreen, or a DIY mask which you have used in the past and which has worked for you. Otherwise, do not look at social media posts and try new things.
All right. And the most common question which everyone has in mind is like using so much sanitizers and repetitive washing our hands. Our hands are going so much dry. So can you just recommend something on that?
Yeah, one very simple thing that you can do is every time you wash your hands or you sanitize them, just apply a moisturizer. And nothing works like coconut oil. If you are using coconut oil every time after you wash your hands or apply a sanitizer, there'll be no chance of a reaction. It's like a sanitizer is also alcohol, right? Same thing that a toner does to your face, the sanitizer is doing to your hands. It's drying out, taking away the lipids. So all we need to do is put the lipids back into your hands and you'll be good.
All right. Thank you so much. And we have someone asking us about the blackheads, like, you know, if any procedure to remove blackheads at home because of the lockdown, we can't travel to the parlors. So how do we remove these blackheads?
Simple thing. What you can do is you can make a little paste of oats and milk or almond and milk and apply it to your nose and then give it a gentle scrub at night. That's it.
Okay.
That should help in removing the blackheads. If you have those blackhead removal strips, you can try with those. But personally, I find the scrubbing will help in removing. Don't try to be over vigorous. That is the bottom line. If you can't remove all the blackheads in one go, try the next day or maybe the next day.
All right. Thank you so much. And yes, I think we have answered most of the queries of everyone. Yeah, so thank you so much, Dr. Vidushi, and each one of you for your precious time. It was such a wonderful session, and for all those tips, I think everyone has noted down. So a big thank you to everyone. At last, stay home, stay safe, everyone.
Thank you so much. It's been lovely talking to all of you.